Hello friends, here in this video we will see some important definitions which are necessary to understand the chapter of principal stresses and planes. Let us get started. The first definition is of resultant stress. Now, for resultant stress, first I'll draw the diagram assuming that there is a plane. Here I'll say that this xx indicates a plane. Now on this plane there is a vertical stress which I'll call it as the normal stress sigma n. Then let there be a tangential stress sigma t which is acting along the plane. So one stress is perpendicular to the plane, other is acting parallel to the plane. Now if I join them, here this hypotenuse of this right angle triangle, this is nothing but the resultant stress. So I'll say that resultant stress is, it is the resultant of normal stress and sigma t, that is tangential stress. Then it is denoted by sigma suffix r, and since it is stress, the unit will be newton per mm square, newton per meter square, or newton per centimeter square. So its unit will be newton per mm square or newton per centimeter square or newton per meter square. Now here I have written the first definition, that is resultant stress. After that, angle of obliquity. Now angle of obliquity, it is the angle made by resultant stress with normal stress. So the angle made by the resultant stress with the normal stress is called as angle of obliquity. Then it is denoted by phi, the letter phi, and here I can mark this on the diagram that this angle is phi, angle made by resultant stress with the normal stress. Then here I can write down tan phi is equal to sigma t, that is opposite side, upon adjacent side sigma n, or I can say that phi is equal to tan inverse of sigma t upon sigma n, that is tangential stress upon normal stress. So this is the formula to calculate the angle of obliquity. We have seen two definitions, resultant stress and angle of obliquity. Now the third definition, that is principal plane. Now principal plane is a plane which carries only normal stress and no tangential stress is called a principal plane. So here is the definition of principal plane, that a plane which carries only normal stress, that is only the value of sigma n and no tangential stress, that is no sigma t. If a plane contains only sigma n, that is normal stress, that would be called as a principal plane. Next, principal stress. Now, I can say that the value or magnitude of stress acting on a principal plane is called as a principal stress. So, first, principal plane, a plane which carries only normal stress and no tangential stress, that is the principal plane. Next, the value of stress, that is the normal stress value which is there on the principal plane, is called as principal stress. Next, the major principal stress. Now, major principal stress is the maximum value of stress, that is normal stress, acting on principal plane is called as major principal stress. So, the maximum value of stress on the principal plane, that would be called as major principal stress. Next, minor principal stress. The minimum value of stress acting on a principal plane is called as minor principal stress. So, the least value of stress which would be acting on the principal plane called as minor principal stress. So, now after minor principal stress, the next definition is major principal plane. Now, a plane which carries maximum normal stress is called as major principal plane. So, the plane which carries the maximum value of normal stress, that would be called as major principal plane. Then we have minor principal plane. So here, a plane which carries minimum normal stress is called as minor principal plane. So here, that plane which carries minimum normal stress would be called as minor principal plane. The plane which carries maximum normal stress is called as major principal plane. So here, we have seen in this video various definitions, or I can say some important definitions to be used in principal stresses and planes, because when we understand these definitions, then only we can understand what we have to find in the problem or what are the unknown values to be calculated, and for that you should know these terms. So first we have seen resultant stress, which was the resultant of normal and tangential stress. Then we have seen angle of obliquity, which is the angle made by resultant stress with the normal stress. Next, we have seen principal plane, a plane which carries only normal stress and no tangential stress, that is called as principal plane. Next, we have seen principal stresses, the value of or magnitude of stresses acting on the principal plane is called as principal stresses. Then major principal stresses, the maximum value of normal stress acting on the principal plane is called as major principal stress. Then the minimum value of normal stress acting on the principal plane is called as minor principal stress. Next, major principal plane, a plane which carries maximum normal stress called as major principal plane. The plane which carries minimum normal stress is called as minor principal plane. And with this, we complete the definition part.